Morph transition is more than just an average transition. It's a tool you can use to create eye-catching visual effects for a photo gallery. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to do just that. Stay tuned. If you're not subscribed or following me, well, you're going to miss out when I drop new videos. And if you're new to Morph transition or need a refresher, then I highly suggest starting with this episode. Find the link below. Otherwise, the first thing we need to do is insert the photos we want to use in the gallery. Then resize them and make sure they all have the same width and height. Now let's arrange the photos horizontally along the bottom of the slide and reduce their transparency by 50%. Once that is done, I'll add a title text right at the center of the slide. Here is where it gets interesting. First, let's duplicate slide 1. I'm going to move the title text out of the way. Bring up the first photo from left and move the rest of the photos to cover up the space. Now let's restore its full transparency. Then increase the size of the photo to cover about 2/3 of the slide and place it on the left side. To complete this part, I will add a description and a title for this iconic photo from NASA. From this point forward, it's a piece of cake. All we need to do is duplicate the previous slide and resize the previous image to match the size of the others. Then we'll swap its position with the image we've selected for this slide. Of course, we must reduce its transparency by 50%. Just like we did with the first image, we'll bring back the transparency of this second image and shift the images at the bottom to the left, creating a dynamic visual flow. Now we can increase its size and carefully position this image, adding a description and a title to its right. And that's it. For the rest of the photos, we just have to repeat step 3. And to not waste your time, I will fast forward the video while I grab a glass of water during this time. Now, here we find ourselves at the final slide. Let's resize this image of a monolith, put it back in the group, and return them all to their original positions. Following that, I'll do same for the title text after I get rid of the previous text. And now, let's join it over to the slide pane and select all the duplicated slides. I'll head over to Transitions tab and click on Morph. Ladies and gentlemen, as we run slideshow and progress through to the next slides, you'll notice smooth transitions from one photo to another, while the ones on the bottom move forward, all thanks to our extraordinary Morph transition. Hey, you've made it to the end of this video. I have a lot more that you're going to find interesting. Just click to watch the next one, and make sure to subscribe to always know when I post new videos.